above the trenches. That's gonna be part 3, I believe. Just left off on Anthony Fokker, Fokkr. Please consider subscribing, and without any further ado, here's chapter 7. We wrap up 1915 with 3 American pilots going home. Were they injured? No, they went home for Christmas break. The French Foreign Legion had a Christmas break? They weren't legionnaires anymore. Now they were pilots. SS Rotterdam, Holland, American Line, Atlantic Ocean, December 1915. We'll only have 8 days at home, but it'll be nice to have some quiet family time. The hero pilots have returned! Snap! Flash! Hooray! Boo! We are supposed to be a neutral country, politician. Who cares? Look at the hero pilots! French ambassador. Look at how much publicity they are getting. Maybe this will finally get America into the war. Send word to the French air minister. The American pilots are generating goodwill for the war in France. German ambassador. They should be in jail! So much for our quiet holiday. Let's get back to France. Wow, the years are flying by. Excuse me, may I please have my metaphor mixed? I'd like to see some flying bunny babies. Technically, they wouldn't be babies. They would be 11-year-olds. In 1916, the airplane is 13 years old, and they wouldn't be bunnies since American planes aren't involved yet. Make it so. I should have never agreed to this. I have no words. In January of 1916, Germany's top pilots, Oswald Bolick and Maximilian Mann, were awarded the Polymeriot, known as the Blue Max. Hey, that's Manfred's buddy. The German papers made these men into stars. Their victories and kill counts became a source of national pride. Paris, France, January 1916. France decided to invest in pilot publicity too. French pilots became famous. It was even decided that having an American squadron would be good publicity. That's one too many publicities to say. Your request for a schedule made entirely of American pilots is granted. Excellent! You must be able to pass French flight training and follow French military regulations. Yes, sir. And the pilots will be American. And though the pilots will be American, the officers will be French. You will be a Schedule N-124. And for Newport planes, sir? Yes, as you know, each schedule has the initial of the plane it uses. You will fly Newports. Gather all the American pilots to the town of Le Plessis, Belleville, until you find an aerodrome for you. Aerodrome. I keep forgetting that's how it's pronounced. Luix Les Bains, France, April 20th, 1916. What luck! Our aerodrome is next to a town famous for its hot springs. Romans built this place. It's lots of beautiful history and architecture here. This pink granite looks to be from Louis the 15th's era. Always the art student, eh, Chapman? Room for another American pilot? Who are you? James McConnell, glad to meet you. Were you a legionnaire? American Ambulance Field Service, Section 2. Earned a Croix de Guerre for courage and fearlessness. A driver, eh? Good with machines, I hope. I was the first person to drive an automobile from Chicago to New York. New Yorker? I'm from all over. Chicago, New York City, North Carolina. spent a lot of years here in France, then went to school at the University of Virginia. When did you graduate?
I never did.
I may or may not have been expelled.
You were kicked out of university?
I was president of the Hot Foot Society. King of it, actually. We were pranksters. I may have taken one prank too far.
What did you do?
There was a grand unveiling planned for a new statue. For this momentous occasion, President Taft was on campus, along with quite a few mucky mucks. Little did they know that I, Jimmy McConnell, king of the Hot Foot Society, had a jolly surprise hidden under the sheet.
Why the kilt?
It is the tartan regalia of my clan. I also used to carry around bagpipes to annoy people with.
You truly were a prankster.
It is with great solemnity and honor that I present the statue of our university's esteemed founder, President Thomas Jefferson.
This is an outrage! Oh my stars! Cover it back up!
You put a chamber pot on Jefferson's head?
Ha!
Welcome to the Escadrille, McConnell. Reader, a chamber pot was what the people used before the toilet was invented. So, when you hear the term piss in pots, that's where you get it. A toilet on Thomas Jefferson's head. Solid prank. I give it 10 out of 10 points.
Prince, you've been awfully quiet. What's your story?
Did you come up through the Foreign Legion or drive in ambulances?
Neither.
How'd you get in?
I grew up in France. I was a trained pilot before the war.
Ain't that lucky?
Be nice to my friend, Prince. He's the one who's been pestering the French government to make this a schedule. If it wasn't for him, we wouldn't be here.
Boy, oh boy. Old Vanderbilt didn't skimp on us.
William Vanderbilt, the wealthy American?
Yep, he's living in Paris these days, and he forked out the cash for our new schedule. An army of mechanics, our own telephone switchboard, and all trucks to carry them all in.
Incredible! It's everything we need.
Everything but the planes. I am Captain George Thénault. I will be the commanding officer for this schedule.
Captain Thénault, sir.
No new puts?
Unfortunately, not yet.
The Battle of Verdun is eating up all the new planes.
We are enjoying being stationed in such luxury, sir.
The luxury is nice, but we chose this place strategically for our bombers.
Is this the farm used by the Red Pirate?
Yes, this is his base.
Really? He's here?
I heard the Germans put a 25,000 mark reward on his head.
Wow.
Yes, he has personally bombed the Friedrichshafen Zeppelin factory 4 times.
Would you like to meet the old Corsair Rouge?
Captain Hop, we will call him.
You American pilots?
Yes, sir. Here to join the flying flight.
Do you see these boxes?
They are Croix de Guerre medals. 8 of them.
I can't wait to earn one of those.
These are for the dead. One for each of the pilots lost on my last mission.
See this one?
This pilot hurled himself, burning from his plane, onto the plane of the German who shot him. They both died in flames.
Get ready as fast as you can. We need all the help we can get.
All we need are our planes. Le Duc Le Blanc, France, late April, 1916.
What's that?
Germans! It's the air raid signal!
Aw, we have no planes to fight back!
Curse you, German dogs! The Germans are eagles, the British are the dogs. They won't be so brave when we get our wings.
Chapter 8.
Leux Lebrun, France, May 1st, 1916.
Paris has finally sent our babies. There are 6 new planes. The 3 babies will go to Kiffin, Chapman, and McConnell.
Woohoo! Babies?
The new Port 11 was called Bibi because it was so small and maneuverable. The other 3 are Newport 16s, same as the babies, but with bigger engines. Thaw, you'll fly one of these. Who gets the other 2? Myself and my lieutenant, Alfred de la Moux de Moux. L'Arge de Moux. What's Prince gonna fly?
He's on leave in Paris.
He's always in Paris. He's still pestering the government about our little American escadrille. I say he's more likely pestering the Parisian girls.
When will they be ready to fly?
It will take several days for our Newport-certified mechanics to assemble them. We'll mount the machine guns when they arrive.
Aw, we don't have guns yet?
Lux Le Bon, France, May 5th, 1916. Can I paint my initial on the side? It's your plane. Paint what you like. R for Rockwell. Check out mine.
What is that?
I'm king of the Hot Foot Society. That's our logo.
Even though we don't have guns, it would be wise to learn your plane's ability.
With these new babies, you can do many maneuvers. The barrel roll, the spin, and the loop-de-loop.
I don't like the look of those clouds. It would be wise to wait for a clearer day.
I've waited long enough. I'll be fine. Test flight number 1. Here goes.
Wow, this plane wants to dance.
Huh?
What? Whoa!
Amazing flying. That gal came out of nowhere.
Kiffin was lucky. The same sudden burst of wind hit the French observation balloons at the front.
Parachutes!
The men in the observation balloons have parachutes. Why didn't these pilots? Military High Command didn't want pilots bailing out of planes that could be saved. They valued the planes more than the pilots?
There were a limited number of planes, but more than enough men willing to volunteer for flight.
So they didn't give them parachutes?
No parachutes.
Our Lewis guns have arrived.
I wish we had machine guns like the Fokkers. That might be a problem. Yeah, I gotta hurry up for this. This will give you 27 cartridges. The reason I have to hurry up is so that way my battery doesn't die.
If you hold the trigger, you will have a single 5-second burst if it doesn't jam. The Fokkers still have better guns, but you will have better planes. Their shots won't matter when you can outmaneuver them.
Luix Le Bon, France, May 15th, 1916. We have our first orders.
Are we escorting the Red Pirates bomber squad?
Not yet. This morning will be routine patrol duty. 5 armed planes in formation.
I've never flown in formation before.
I've never fired a machine gun. Also, while up there, I'd like each of you to practice reloading your guns.
Brr, nobody tells you how cold it gets up here.
Gotta be careful with my shots. Reloading is a nightmare.
We're over enemy territory now, but it sure is beautiful here.
Did you boys start the fight without me?
Bert Hall, the man, the legend. Check out my new port, French from Paris.
Treb?
That says Bert to the pilots flying the opposite direction.
Prince and Cowden, back from Paris. Who are your friends?
I brought a few reporters and a movie crew.
They're here to make us all even more famous.
We haven't done anything yet.
Bring the news crew after we shoot down some Germans.
Can all of you Americans sign up for a photo?
Sure.
Alright, can't show the photo, but, maybe next time.
Giffen Rockwell, flying solo with Brother Paul injured. Captain George Thenault, French captain. William Thaw, playboy of the Riviera, not in photo. Norman Prince pressured the French to create the American escadrille. Alfred de Lage de Meux, French lieutenant. Elliot Calvin went home for Christmas. Bert Hall, tall tale teller. James McConnell, king of the Hot Foot Society. Victor Chapman, architecture student. Here are the original members of the escadrille Americaine. Most of these men won't outlive the war. Some won't outlive the year. Verdun, France, March 1916. Chapter 9. Manfred, what is this gun doing on your upper wing? Are you a Frenchman or an Englishman? Why should my observer get to do all this shooting? Looks primitive and sloppy. We're Afropatrol. Let's see how this works. What's he doing? French flying sticks? You hit him, Manfred. He's going down. It won't count as a confirmed kill. We both saw him go down. The wreckage has to be confirmed on the ground. And that's enemy territory on the other side of Fort Dalmont. Unless we go there on foot to confirm the clash, it doesn't count as our victory. It may not count, but I am proud of it anyway. Lourdes, Le Bon, France, May 16, 1916. Wham! 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 Again? Curse them! Was anyone in that tent? Four mechanics. All dead. It seems that the Germans are paying attention to us now. To us. It's barely dawn. How did they see us? They took off in the dark. They planned to be over us right when there was enough light to see. Why didn't we hear their engines? They flew high and cut their engines. I'm patrolling before dawn whether our engine sounds or not. Don't be reckless, Thaw. Lourdes, Le Bon, France, May 18th, 1916. Morning, Thaw. You go up today? No, my machine needs repairs. Don't worry, I'll save some Germans for you. Looks like a quiet day. I need a thicker coat. Wait, what's that? German LVG? A two-seat recon plane? Quack, quack, quack. I felt that. I'm supposed to get in close before I shoot. So here goes. What's this fool dueling? Jam. A jam? Huh? Lucky shot. Huh? Two lucky shots? Crash. Huh? Confirmed kill. The French observers saw the smoke. Huh? It's these American escadrille's first victory. My gun jammed. I fired maybe four shots? Well, they hit. Giffen Rockwell, first kill. Paul Rockwell, Kiffin's brother, heard the news and sent a telegram. I am proud of you and your feat. Mrs. Weeks is too. When I heard the news, I was taking a bath. I did a little war dance around the room. And for your victory, here's something special. Kentucky bourbon, 80 years old? Whoa, open it. Let's all have a drink to celebrate. No, Kiffin, you take a drink. You earned it. Nobody else can have a drink until he has a confirmed kill. We really gonna celebrate death that way? Yes, this is the bottle of death. You get one drink from the bottle of death every time you shoot down a German. The bottle of death. The bottle of death. Gentlemen, I hate to break up the celebration, but we have new orders. Is it time for the escort mission with the Red Pirate? No, we've been ordered to Verdun. That bottle of death won't stay full for long. Chapter 10. Alright, that's where I'm going to pick up tomorrow. See you guys later. Have a good rest of your day. Like, subscribe, support my channel in any way that you can, and I'll see you later. Bye!